Hey everybody. So it looks like Facebook has a new updated version of how we go live. So if anybody's been trying to play around with that, hello. It looks all new to me. As someone who goes live a lot on Facebook. This is a new little interface that's happening. Very, very interesting. All right. So anyhow, hey, everybody. I hope you all have been enjoying the little self-care series that I have going on all this week. We had some of my amazing, talented, smart friends share all their knowledge about self-care with us. Every day this week, starting on Monday. So today, I just kind of want to recap some of the amazing stuff that they shared with us. That way, if you missed it, you know where to go find it. Or if you did watch it live, maybe just to remind you of some of the things that we learned. And then also today, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about nail care and what we can be doing to keep our nails healthy and strong while we're at home, and just always, and that goes for everything we learned this week. You know, the whole purpose of me putting this together was to maybe try to ease the pain of us not being able to get to our salons and get like all the professional services that we're used to getting, and what we can do to help ourselves at home. But really, all of the stuff that we learned all week, we can be doing all the time, even after we get back into our salons, just things that we can be doing at home to make our hair better, our skin better, our makeup techniques better, all of those things. So let's just, before I get into the nails, I just want to recap what we learned this week. So Monday, we talked with Miranda about skincare, which is such a great thing. I always learn so much from her. As someone, like, I don't know how to say this. I don't want to say don't care about my looks, because, like, of course I do, but I work from home, so it's not always my top priority every day. Like, I am not the person that wakes up in the morning and the first thing I do is like put my makeup on. In fact, it's very far from that. I only do that when I have to go somewhere or if I'm going live. So skincare lately has been something that, like, I kind of have been sliding on. Like, I used to wash my face religiously as a teenager, and even up over these past 10 years, like every morning and every night. And then I really slacked off probably like this past year. And talking to Miranda on Monday made me realize that I really need to get back into the swing of things. Like, especially when she talked about like the places on us that age first, being like our hands and this part of our neck. So, and like the key takeaway from Miranda was moisturize, moisturize, moisturize. And that advice also carries on into our nails, which is what we're going to talk about today, especially because we are all washing our hands way more than we ever have before. I mean, and I was a pretty avid hand washer before. I mean, I was the person that always had like a little anti-vac in my purse. I was constantly using it like before we ate, or when I came in into my car after pumping gas, or using an ATM, or being in a store. But now I find myself even 20 times throughout the day in my own house after I touch something where I'm second guessing if I remember to wipe it off or not. I'm washing my hands again, washing before I eat at home. So if you all seen that little meme going around Facebook lately that said, I never thought my hands would consume more alcohol than my mouth. And here we are. And it's so true. My hands are consuming so much alcohol. So with that, they're very dry and scaly, and there's cracks. And we want to prevent that, because when you have dry and scaly hands and cracks, that's just more little creases and crevices for germs to kind of sneak in and stay put on your hands. And obviously, we want to avoid that. So keeping our hands not only clean, but moisturized are going to help with a couple of things. They're going to help with the aging of our hands, which is what we learned from Miranda. And it's going to help with keeping our cuticles and our nails moisturized as well, which then in turn gives us stronger, healthier looking nails, which is what we all want. So that was awesome that we learned from Miranda. And then on Tuesday, we talked to Zanetta, which was, oh gosh, that was such an awesome thing to watch her do, like half of her face with makeup. She gave us like a really simple, doable, at home look that, you know, we don't look overdone, but we feel good about ourselves, and some awesome tips about how and why we should look good for like Zoom meetings and on camera. And she brought up such a great point that not only are people working from home and they're, you know, video conferencing at home for work these days, but also job interviews themselves are kind of turning to this point where you just do your job interview right over a computer like this. So we really want to hone in on those skills and learn how we can look our best through our webcam, through makeup tips and also lighting. So if you didn't catch Tuesdays, you'll want to look back and find that one and listen to her, to her conversation with me. And then yesterday we talked to Lauren about at-home hair care, which was like the greatest information. Everybody was just asking her tons of questions about how we could take care of our hair and how we can keep it healthy until we can get back to her, the salons. And one of my favorite things that Lauren said to us yesterday was, you know, wait for your hairstylist. Like, don't, it's because what's going to happen is when we are all off of this lockdown, everybody's going to be flooding back to their salon, right? They're just going to be like pushing the doors down, trying to get in and trying to get an appointment. And you might not get in as soon as you want to. So you may get a little desperate and maybe book an appointment with another hairstylist. And Lauren reminded us all and encouraged us all to please just wait for your regular hairstylist and go back to her or him, because they need us just as much as we need them. That's their income, and they put their heart and soul into making us look good and learning our hair and learning what's best for us. And we need to do them justice by waiting to get into that appointment with them. So her suggestions were, you know, to create a personal relationship with your hairstylist, make sure you know how to get in touch with them on social media, so that you are staying up to date on when that salon is opening back up and how and when they are booking appointments to get everybody back in and back on the schedule, so that you aren't feeling desperate and running off to somebody else. So that was a great takeaway. And then tomorrow we are going to talk to Monica Dean. She is going to talk to us about oils and yoga. So some easy yoga poses that we can be doing at home so that we feel good and stay stretched out, since some of us are not as active as we normally are on our day-to-day basis because we're stuck at home now. So these are things we can be doing at home to stay healthy. And then of course, my favorite part is she's going to talk about essential oils, which I don't know about you guys, but I have a huge collection of essential oils. I love them. I love the smell of them. I love the way they make me feel. I love how I can use them to put myself to sleep or uplift my mood. And so she's going to talk to us about that tomorrow. But for today, let's just talk quickly about keeping our nails healthy. So first, I want to address all my girls out there that can't get to their nail salon, that are usually there religiously. And this is really important that I want to say this. I know that all of us out there, my Color Street girls, we are so happy to be able to help you guys through this time by giving you another option to have your nails look beautiful at home. But I can't stress this enough. None of us in any way, shape, or form are trying to take you away from your regular salon. If I don't want you guys to take this in the wrong way when we're like, try Color Street. You know, obviously we want you to try Color Street. Obviously we want to help you fill in your grow outs and help ease the pain of you not having your acrylics. But I don't want any of the girls out there that own nail salons to think that we're in any way trying to step on your toes. We really just are trying to help take care of your customers while they can't get back to you. And we also encourage all of you girls that go get acrylics put on regularly or gel or get your nails dipped if that's what you prefer to do. You know, we want to help you with Color Street in the meantime, but you know, we also want to see you get back to your favorite salon. And just so you know, even when you do get back, if you love the look of Color Street can go on top of acrylics and gel and nail strip. You can still use the strips on top of those things, and you can still use them in between your fills to help ease the pain until you can get back to your salon. So just so you guys are aware of that. Now, with that being said, if there are any girls that are, you know, maybe you use Color Street to fill in your gaps of your acrylics, and now your acrylics are so far grown out that you're ready to pop them off, I want to offer you some tips today on maybe which type of Color Street you might want to try out first and why. So, as many of you know, taking off the acrylics is really important. It's really important to pay attention to how you do that. Like if you're doing it proper and you're soaking them off and you're easing them off and you're doing as least amount of damage as you possibly can to the nail surface, that's obviously the best way to do it. I know that some of you kind of lose patience and you just pop them off, you know, and then you've got, you've created some damage to the nail surface and it's peeling and jaggy and whatnot. So if that's happening, before you just jump to throwing some Color Street on top of it, you do want to prep your nails. You want to make sure that you are filing them and buffing them and trying to make that surface as smooth as possible before you put your Color Street on, especially if you're going to be going straight to a solid. So these are for my girls that for whatever reason don't like the glitter or the design. You just would rather stick to a solid color on your hand. It's so important to not skip the nail prep part of the process. You want to make sure that you are filing and you're buffing so that you're creating a smooth surface, a smooth foundation before you put the Color Street on. I've done videos about this in the past. I like to refer to our solids as like the bodycon dresses of Color Street. You know, like, you know what I mean by bodycon dress, like the little dresses that you'd wear to the club that are like super tight and they show any little flaw that you have in your body, like any little fat roll, any little cellulite, like you can see it all because they're so tight. That's kind of like what a Color Street solid would be. If you have ridges in your nail, if you have bumps in your nail, if you didn't push your cuticles back the whole way, you're gonna see those little flaws within your nail when you put the solid on top. So to buff all that out, push all your cuticles back, get them prepped the best you can, especially if you're going to do solids. Now, after you've done that and maybe you still have some roughness and you can't get it out completely and you don't want to see flaws, if that bothers you, if you have a little bit of OCD about that, then I'm going to suggest that you try one of our glitters, because the glitters reflect the light and they're a little bit thicker because of the glitter. So remember, Color Street is a base coat, a color, and a top coat. So you do have three layers of polish. So when you're using glitter, that middle layer of polish obviously is a little thicker because you're dealing with the texture of glitter. So it's going to help hide any flaws that you have on your fingers. And it's the same when you use the nail art designs, because the art itself may help to camouflage or disguise any imperfections that you have on your nail base. So just keep that in mind if you're transitioning over and you want to be very particular about the way any flaws might come through in your hand. Just keep that in mind when you're picking out the Color Street. So it's just like when you're picking out your clothes, you have to pick out the right style that fits you. You have to pick out the right style of Color Street that's going to fit your type of nails. So with that said, you also want to make sure that when you are transitioning into your natural nails, that you're growing your nails out to the length that fits your lifestyle and the type of nail that you have. So some of us have really thick, hard nails. I envy you girls that have that. I have my nails tend to grow very thin, flimsy. They're dry naturally, so I have to constantly moisturize my nails. So just like our skin and just like our hair that we learned from Miranda and Lauren, our nails, some of us have oily nails, some of us have really dry nails. So it's really important that we learn what type of nail we have too. So we learned this week, you know, we were encouraged by Miranda and Lauren to wash our face. Miranda said, wash your face and don't put any makeup, moisturizer, anything on it for a whole day and see how you're, see what the natural state of your skin is, because a lot of us have never taken the time to do that, right? Because we have busy work schedules and we just get up in the morning. It's just part of our routine. We wash our face and then immediately slap on moisturizer, immediately cover it up with makeup, and off we go. We never really just let our skin be in its natural state. And so some of us, maybe the last time we did that was many years ago as a teenager, we had oily skin, and here we are as adults, our skin is dry now and we don't even know it because we're just immediately covering up with product. So just like that, this is a good time if you always had acrylics on your hand, or even if you always wore nail polish or even color street, this is just a really good time to let your nails be. Just take everything off of it for a couple days and see, are your nails dry? Do they peel really easy? Or are they very oily? Are they naturally thick? Just take a look at them and figure out what they are. That way you know how to treat them. But I'm gonna say this, because we are all washing our hands so much, even if you have, even if your nails aren't typically dry or they're not naturally thin, you're probably experiencing some type of dryness now just because we are washing them so much, right, guys? So I would just kind of go out on a limb and say, keep a bottle of moisturizer or cuticle oil or whatever it is that you use right next to your kitchen sink. So immediately after washing your hands, you're putting moisturizer on there. So here's some things to know about our nails. So our nails grow in layers naturally. And when we use our nails as tools, we are bending them. Even if they're strong nails, if you're putting any kind of pressure on the tip of your nails, you are bending them. And if you've ever taken anything, even if you've taken like a stack of paper here, even if you just take like a stack of paper, this would be layers of paper, and I bend them, they're going to start coming apart in some areas. It's the same thing that's happening with your nails. So anytime you stub your nail on something or use it to scrape your dishes, or if you're scraping, you know, maybe you're cleaning your bathtub with something and your nails are scraping the sides of the tub or whatever it is, maybe you just go to pick something up and you grabbed a little too hard and your nail hits the table. Any kind of pressure that you put on that nail is going to cause them to bend, and therefore it's going to like lessen the integrity of those layers. So we always want to just make sure that we are being very careful with our nails. And if you are a person who has thin nails and you just can't be careful, maybe you just live the lifestyle where you're just really hard on your nails, because I'm guilty of that. You might want to consider just keeping your nails at a shorter length so that they're not sticking out past the edge of your fingertips and they're less likely to hit onto things and bend and break. Because if they do break, if you have any kind of trauma on your nails, it typically takes about 6 months for a nail to grow out to its full length. So that's 6 whole months for you to grow out any damage that you may have done to the nails. So just keep that in mind. The next time you want to open a bottle, a pop or something and use your nails, just hand it off to like someone with rugged hands. The nearest guy next to you or whatever, just have them open it, or maybe just be in the habit of carrying some type of tool in your keychain or whatever that you are going to use as the tool instead of your fingernails. So that's the number one tip. Don't use your nails as tools if you want them to grow out. Here's another thing that is really cool to know if you're going to be growing out your natural nails, is if you do want to add some length to them, if you do like to have longer nails, you can pretty much shape them to any shape that you want. But the key to getting them to grow long is to keep the edges completely parallel until they are past the edge of the tip of your finger. And then you can shape them. So in other words, if you wanted to do like a point, you know, like a little pointy nail like that, that's great. But don't file them to a point until they've completely grown out past the tip of your nail. So if you look at your finger from behind, you want them to be completely parallel past the edge of your finger. And then you can start shaping them. Don't start making the shape down low, because if you do, there's not going to be a solid enough foundation, and the nail is just going to break off. So always try to keep them parallel, just past the tip of your finger, and then shape the nail into whatever shape you prefer, whether you like square or coffin or points. There's all kind of different nail shapes out there. They're not one size fits all. You gotta do it to whatever your lifestyle is. I don't want to give too much away. I was going to give you guys some tips on what you can use to moisturize, but I think I'm going to wait until tomorrow when we're talking to Monica about oils, because I have some little tinctures of oils that I've mixed up myself that I use. I created my own cuticle oil that works amazing. But I'm going to wait and share that recipe with you guys tomorrow when we're talking to Monica about essential oils, because she may have something to add to that. So we'll kind of do that topic tomorrow. And let me see what else. And a few more things I wanted to talk to you guys about. So I talked about not using your fingers or not using your nails as tools, the 6 month grow out. Here's another thing. I love that Lauren said this yesterday. If you guys tuned in yesterday, you remember how Lauren said, she said not to put your hair slicked back tight while it's wet, because when your hair is wet, it's more vulnerable and it's more apt to start breaking. Your nails are the same way. So if you're doing dishes, soaking them in water, if you're in a pool, after you're in the shower, like when your nails are wet, before you do any heavy duty working around the house or anything that may cause potential damage to your nail, make sure you don't start doing that until your nails are dry. So give it 10, 15 minutes after you got out of the shower, or 10 or 15 minutes after you get out of the pool, or 10 or 15 minutes after you've done the dishes, to start doing anything that may cause damage to your nails. You want to make sure they dry completely, because if you start doing it while the nail is wet and like when they're wet, they're kind of like noodles, right? They're like weird. If you get bendy nails, they're really bendy when they're wet, right? So you want to wait until they dry. That's another really good tip, especially for those of us that are washing our hands constantly. So just be mindful of the fact that your nails are more vulnerable when they are wet. So you want to wash them, put your moisturizer on, make sure they're going to dry before you go back to doing anything that is, you know, where you're using your hands and you're causing any damage to the tips of your nails. If you want them to look their best, you can also wear cotton lined gloves when you're doing dishes. That way they're not rubbing on anything rough, and creating any unnecessary friction on the nail surface. But as always, the best way to protect your nail surface is, of course, to have polish on it. So not only is nail polish something that we use to make our nails look beautiful, but it's also a protectant, right? It's also protecting the nails. It's helping add integrity to the structure of the nail. So if you do have weak nails, if you're wearing nail polish, or especially Color Street with three layers right on it, boom, you're helping to make your nails a little bit more durable and protected. It's like body armor for your nails. So, which is another reason why I love that we have the clear strip, clear as day. Some of you that just maybe you don't like to have nail polish on. I have a lot of friends that just don't like nail polish. They feel like it's distracting. Monica says her list keeps getting longer for tomorrow. So if you are a person that doesn't like to have color on your nails, you may want to consider just grabbing a couple packs of Clear as Day, just to have that clear polish on your nails, just to protect your nails during all of this hand washing. So I think some people just automatically think that nail polish is like a vanity thing, that it's just a beauty product. And in most cases it is. But during this time, especially during this time, it's also just something that's necessary, just to take care of your body, take care of your nails, because you don't want them to bend. You know, if anybody has ever bent their fingernail down past the bottom edge of their nail, you know that that hurts, right? So we don't want that to happen, because as we're washing and we're drying out our nails and they're wet constantly, they're more vulnerable to breakage and bending. So you can protect them with either a color or a coat of, clear as day. let's see what else. This is so hard when I'm doing this by myself. I miss having another person to talk to and bounce questions and ideas off of. I should have invited someone on here with me today instead of going for it by myself. Let's see. Going over my notes here on my computer. It's really pretty much the gist of it. Like I said, I'm going to talk more about moisturizing tomorrow when I'm on with Miss Monica. And if anybody has any specific questions for me about nail care, about Color Street, about transitioning, or if maybe you just have any specific questions, just like maybe you're not even sure what Color Street is at this point. Maybe you've heard about it, you hear everybody's hyped about it, you're wondering, but I'm a acrylic wearer, how will this help me? Just reach out to me. I will show you some videos of how people are using it to transition. And that's, oh, hey, Amy, thank you. So yeah, that's it. I just kind of wanted to come on here, just to continue our little series, with Monica tomorrow and later tonight. I'm also going to hop on here, and do a live with my husband. Me and the girls have a little something funny we're going to do with him later on tonight. So yeah, make sure you look for that. All right, guys. So I'm going to hop off of here and I will see you all later. Bye.